is a transversal plane is very important here. What are parallel lines? Attention. What is a transversal? What transversal means? First, I'll discuss transversal. Transversal is a line which intersects two or more lines at distinct points is called transversal. See, here 1, 2, 3 are parallel lines and one more line is drawn here. This is a T. It intersects at two or more points. A, B, C, at 3 points. It intersects a line. This is a line, transversal is a line which intersects two or more lines. See, 1, 2, 3. Two or more lines at distinct points. A, B, C are distinct means different points. Distinct points is called transversal. In the figure, T is a transversal. This is a transversal. It intersects line L, M, L at A, B, C respectively. Why transversal is important? It makes so many types of angles. So the transversal is very important here. Try to understand. Transversal is nothing but it is a line which intersects two or more distinct points. Is called transversal. This is the transversal. Now this makes some types of angles. I said, what are the types of angles? First, corresponding angles. What are corresponding angles here? This transversal makes so many types of angles. First one is corresponding angles. The angles on the same side of the transversal are known as the corresponding angles if both lie either above the two lines or between the two lines. Here one and angle 5. See, either these are corresponding angles are on the same side of the transversal. See, this is the transversal. Either right side or left side of the transversal. On the same side of the transversal, and what is the condition? If both lie either above the two lines or below the two lines. So leave the third line. One, two you have to take. See, here angle 1 and angle 5 are lying on the above the lines. This is the line, this is the side. 1 and 5 are the same side of the transversal and on or above the lines, above this line and above this line. 1 and 5 are corresponding angles. Are below also. Angle 2 and angle 6 below. 2 is below the this L and 6 is below this L. Either above or below the lines, parallel lines, and on the same side of the transversal are corresponding angles. Here angle 1, angle 5, angle 2 and angle 6 are corresponding angles. Similarly, left side, angle 4, angle 8, above. Lines, angle 3 and angle 7 are below the lines. See, angle 1 and angle 5, angle 2 and angle 6, angle 4 and angle 8, angle 3 and angle 7. These are corresponding angles. Corresponding angles are nothing but angles on the same side of the transversal, but they lie either above the lines, parallel lines, or below the lines. These are corresponding angles. By using the corresponding angles, we have some theorems. Corresponding angles will be always equal. Okay? So some axioms are there are discussed. This is the first type of angle, corresponding angle. Now I'll discuss the next type of angles, alternate angles. Transversal means corresponding angles. Next, alternate angles. Corresponding angles are discussed. Alternate angles are nothing but what? Angles that are on the opposite sides of the transversal are called alternate angles. Opposite sides. Corresponding angles are nothing but what? They are on the same side of the transversal and those are either upside or downside of the parallel lines. But alternate angles are nothing but what? Angles that are on the opposite side of the transversal are called alternate angles. Opposite sides are nothing but. So this is the transversal. One angle will be this side and another angle will be this side. So either these are based on the either exterior or interior. See, here one is outside and seven is also outside. These two are opposite side of the transversal and exterior. So these are exterior alternate exterior angles. 1 and 7, next 4 and 6, these are exterior. Similarly, 2 and 8, 3 and 5, 2, 8 are opposite, 3, 5 are opposite, but these are interior of the vertebrae. So interior alternate angles. Here also 4 pairs, sorry. Here 2 are interior alternate angles and 2 are exterior alternate angles. Once again, alternate angles that are on the opposite side of the transversal are called alternate angles. Alternate interior angles. See, angle 3 and angle 5 are interior alternate or alternate interior angles. So these are parallelized interior. These two are interior. So this is one pair of interior alternate angles. And similarly, angle 2 and 8 are, these are also interior alternate angles. Next, alternate exterior angles. Angle 4 and angle 6 are exterior. One is this side, other one is opposite side. So these are exterior angles. One pair. Angle 1 and angle 7 are exterior angles. Total 1, 2, 3, 4. All these are alternate angles. 2 are interior alternate angles. 2 are exterior alternate angles. Always alternate angles also will be equal. Here also one exam is there and discuss the exam. Now this is corresponding angles axiom. Already known corresponding angles are nothing but what? Here this is the transversal, these two are parallel lines. One should be exterior and one should be interior of these two parallel lines. They are on the same lines, they are on the same side of the transversal are corresponding angles. Here axiom, axiom is nothing but what? Already accepted statement, proved statement, will be used to prove other statement. Okay, exactly. Accepted statement. Corresponding angles axiom state that if a transversal intersect two parallel lines, see this is a transversal intersect two parallel lines, then each pair of corresponding angles is equal. That is nothing but angle 1 and angle 2, angle 3 and angle 4 are corresponding angles. In the given figure, L is parallel to M, then angle 1 is equal to angle 4. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2 and angle 3 is equal to angle 4 according to the given. Angle 3 is equal to angle 4. See, here angle 1 and angle 2 are corresponding angles, angle 3 and angle 4 are corresponding angles. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, T is a transversal intersect two parallel lines, each pair of corresponding angles is equal. Angle 1, angle 2 is one pair, these two will be equal. Angle 3 and angle 4 are corresponding angles, these two will be always equal. This is the corresponding angle axiom. Next, converse of this corresponding angle axiom is reverse. If these angles are equal, this will be transversal, these two lines will be parallel. See, if a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of corresponding angles is equal, then the two lines are parallel to each other. If a transversal intersects two lines, this transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of corresponding angles is equal. If these two corresponding angles are equal, then the two lines are parallel to each other. If these two lines corresponding angles are equal, these corresponding angles are equal, this transversal intersect here, so these two lines will be parallel. Corresponding angle, converse of corresponding angle. So in the above figure, angle 1 is equal to angle 2 and angle 3 is equal to angle 4, then L is parallel to M. If these corresponding angles are equal, we can say these two lines are parallel to each other. This is the converse of corresponding angle axiom. Previous equations. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior alternate angles is equal. This is the first theorem. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior alternate angles is equal. Here AB and CD are two parallel lines, T is a transversal. AB, it is given that according to statement, what is given here? You have to draw the diagram first, later you have to write according to your statement. AB and CD are two parallel lines, AB and CD are two parallel lines, transversal T intersects at P and Q. At P and Q respectively, it makes angle 4 and angle 5 over interior angles, and angle 3 and angle 8 are interior angles. What you have to prove? Interior angles are equal. Angle 4 is equal to angle 5 you have to prove, and angle 3 is equal to angle 8. We need to prove. So, angle 4 is equal to angle 8. See, angle 4 is equal to angle 8. Sorry, angle 4 is equal to angle 2. Angle 4 and angle 2 are vertical opposite angles. Vertical opposite angles, say equation number 1. And angle 2 is equal to angle 5. 4 and 2 have taken, and 2 and 5, these are corresponding angles. Corresponding angles of square root will be equal. Say this is equation number 2. From equation number 1 and 2, it implies that angle 4 is equal to angle 2. See, angle 2 is equal to angle 5, something about that is equal to angle 5. Angle 4 is equal to 2, and angle 2 is equal to angle 5. So, angle 4 is equal to 2, that is equal to angle 5. It indicates what all these are equal. We can say angle 4 is equal to angle 5. This is nothing but these two are interior alternate angles. Similarly, we can prove angle 3 is equal to angle 3 is equal to angle 8. So, angle 3 is equal to angle 8. Numbers are over you have to do, but you have to write properly. Angle 3 is equal to angle 8. These two are alternate interior. And this is the proof about if a transversal intersects two parallels, then each pair of interior alternate will be equal. This is the theorem. Now, converse of this theorem is reverse statement. If a transversal intersects two lines in such a way that a pair of alternate angles are equal, then the two lines are parallel. If a transversal intersects two lines in such a way that pair of alternate interior angles are equal, it is equal to angle 4 is equal to angle 5 and angle 3 is equal to angle 8, then we say these two lines are parallel to each other. We need to prove. To prove AB is parallel to CD, it is given that these two are here 3A is equal to 8, 5 is equal to 4. It is given T is a transversal. We need to prove AB is parallel to CD. To prove AB is parallel to CD, prove angle 4 is equal to angle 5. Angle 4 is equal to angle 5 because it is given already interior alternate angles are equal according to your set. Next, angle 4 is equal to angle 2. Angle 4 is equal to angle 2. These two are vertically opposite angles. These two are vertically opposite angles. Say this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. From 1 and 2, both adjacencies are 4, angle 4 only. So we can say angle 5 is equal to angle 2. Angle 2 is equal to angle 5 or angle 2 is equal to. See, angle 2 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. These are corresponding angles. Therefore, according to corresponding angles axiom, these two corresponding angles are equal, then we can say these two are parallel to each other according to the corresponding angle axiom. Therefore, by corresponding angle axiom, AB is parallel to CD. This is the converse of theorem 1. Theorem 1 states that if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior alternate angles are equal. So, these interior alternate angles are equal. These are parallel. We need to prove these alternate angles are equal. If alternate angles are equal, we need to prove these two lines are parallel to each other. That is a converse of the first theorem. Theorem and converse. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is symmetric. Once again, if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is symmetric. These two are parallel lines. T is a transversal here. It is given that AB is parallel to CD. Transversal T intersects AB and CD at P and Q here. This is P, this is Q. And makes interior angles on the same side. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4. Okay? So, to prove angle 1 plus angle 2 means sum of these two on the same side of the transversal, those are interior, those will be supplementary, means angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 and angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180. We are going to prove. Proof. Where PB stands on, this PB stands on the transversal T. Transversal T. Therefore, angle 5 plus angle 1 is equal to 180 because this is a linear ray. This is a ray. These two are opposite rays. Okay? Angle 5 plus angle 1 is equal to 180. 1. These two are linear here. Angle 5 is equal to angle 2. See, angle 5 is equal to angle 2. These two are corresponding angles. corresponding, let's say this is equation number 2. Put the angle 5 is equal to angle 2 in equation number 1. In equation number 1, that gives us in this angle 5, we have to put the angle 2 because angle 5 is equal to angle 2. These two are corresponding angles. Angle 5 is equal to angle 2 in 1. Angle 2 plus angle 1 is equal to 180 degrees. So one side completed now. Angle 1 plus angle 2 or angle 2 plus angle 1 is equal to 180 degrees. Next, and ray CQ stands on. Ray CQ, okay, this stands on T again. So angle 4 angle plus angle 6 is equal to 180 degree linear frame. This is also linear frame. Angle 6 is equal to angle 3. Angle 6 is equal to angle 3. These two are corresponding angles. These two are corresponding angles. Put angle 4th equation in 3rd equation. This is you say equation number, this is 4. That gives us angle 4 plus angle 3. Angle 4 plus angle 3 because angle 6 and angle 3 are equal. So angle 4 plus angle 3 is equal to 180 degree. Hence true. It is nothing but angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degree and angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degree. Hence proof. This is a theorem. Proof about theorem. Now converse of this theorem means reverse. If a transversal intersects two lines in such a way that a pair of interior alternate angles, interior angles on the same side are supplementary, then the two lines are parallel. Some of these two are supplementary, we need to prove these two are parallel. If these two are parallel, we need to prove these are supplementary. This is a theorem. If these are supplementary, we need to prove these two lines are parallel to each other. That is converse of the theorem. Given angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 and one angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180. One side just you have to take. To prove AB is parallel to CD, we need to prove AB and CD are parallel. So, since ray AP stands on T, so angle 1 plus angle 3, angle 1 plus angle 3 gives us 180 degree. Say equation number 1, these are linear curve. And one more, angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180, it is given because it is given that transversal intersects two lines in such a way that a pair of interior angles on the same side are supplementary, then the two lines are, say these are supplementary, it is given. From 1 and 2, it implies that both RHSs are 180 degree, so we can compare angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to angle 1 plus angle 2, these two are 180. So 1 get cancelled here, both side 1 is there, angle 3 is equal to angle 2. It indicates what? Angle 3 and angle 2 are interior alternate angles. If interior alternate angles are equal, then we can say these two are parallel to each other. Therefore, AB is parallel to CD. Yes, true. This is the converse of the theorem. This is the theorem. If these two are parallel, these sum of interior angles on the same sides are the same sides are supplementary. This is the theorem. If these two are supplementary, can prove these two are parallel. This is the converse of the theorem.